So here it is, the device that's going to transform archery coaching forever. Let's have a look. The Mantis X8 archery shooting analysis system, so available from all good bow shops now. Wales Archery can get it on special order for you. I believe they're also going to buy one for use in the shop if you don't want to buy your own. Funky looking box. So here's what we're expecting in it. Sensor adapter case cable. Obviously, we've got an app to download to go with this as well. And here are the claims that they're making. A revolutionary shooting system that helps improve your precision, analyzes your shooting mechanics, diagnoses issues, and gives instantaneous feedback. Well, we'll see. Ah, they are serious about my shooting. That's good. So am I. So this is a nice little protective case. That's quite useful. That will slip in your kit bag, no problem. Protect the stuff that's inside. It's nice for manufacturers to actually include something like that, because many people don't now. They just package it in blister packing and then leave you to your own devices with it. So, we have got the unit itself is in that little foam... I go turn the brightness up, is in that little foam cutout there. And we've got some accessories on the other side. We have a pointless sticker. I don't know why people do this. I don't want to free advertise for you guys. Thanks, Mantis, but no, I don't need that. We've got this little package. It's got in it, yeah, the adapter is in it, and some materials, I presume, for fixing the adapter. Let's have a look. Can't get it open. Yeah, so these are instructions for how to fix the adapter on. I'm going to actually follow these for once. And we've got, yeah, cleaning pad and a dry cloth as well. There's the adapter, better not lose that. Can be an awkward thing to replace, I imagine. A sticky pad on the back. And we've got yet another mini USB cable to go with all the millions of others that I have in the house, and no doubt you have in the house as well. Yep, mini USB. Okay, and here is the, just get it out, the unit itself. Dinky wee thing. This is the side that fixes on the adapter. Put that little nub in to locate it, and then this is the side with the power button on. That power button is the one right in the middle there. Charging end. And there we go. Tiny. Doesn't weigh very much at all, so it's not going to throw your feel of your bow out or anything like that. Short press to turn it on and the light flashes. And then... oops. A long press to turn it off. Alright, brilliant. Looks like we've got everything that we need. So there's the unit, there's the charging cable, adapter, dry cloth, wet cloth, and some instructions. Alright, I think we're good to go on and get this fitted.
Okay, so I've got what I need now to do the fixing on of the little adapter. I've got my instructions, which for once I'm actually going to follow because I don't want to mess this up. I've got the sterile, the alcohol pad and the dry pad that came in the kit. So first thing I'm going to do, as the instructions require, is to clean this area of the extension bar where I'm going to put... I'm going to put the adapter. Okay, that'll be plenty clean enough. Then we'll dry it off with a little cloth. There we go. So I mount my sight in the second hole here on the extension bar, so I know that my fixing mount takes up about this much space on the bar. So I'm going to fix the adapter just to this side here, so that I know there's enough space clear. So peel this red tape off is what we need to do next. This is going to be tricky for me because I have short nails. As you can see, I've tried on the corner already and I have not succeeded. So bear with me whilst I faff with this. Finally, thanks to a knife and a pair of tweezers, I've managed to get a corner up and I can get the red tape backing off. There we go. And I'm going to just stick it just short of the little axle logo there. And I need to make sure that I get it square. Then it says firm pressure for 20 seconds. Probably about 20 seconds, good enough. Right, that's the initial fix. I now have to leave this, unfortunately, for 24 hours to cure, so I'm not going to be touching my sight anytime soon. Let's leave it here. And we'll see what the magic of editing can do for our 24-hour period. So, 24 hours have passed, thanks to the miracle of editing, and we are now ready to fix the actual unit because the sticky pad is properly set, properly, what is the word, affixed to the sight track. So, the thing you need to know is that there's a little catch on the unit, hopefully you can see that there, and you need to make sure that that's lifted because it's attached to this little nubbin that sticks out the back of the unit. Here, and if that is down when you're trying to fit the unit, you'll get stuck. It won't push all the way on. So lift that catch there, like that, and then all you need to do is just slide the unit on to the dovetail of the adapter. I'm not very good at showing this. Awkward hands, I do apologise. And push it all the way on, and then make sure that that little catch sits back down again. When it snaps into place, you know that you've got it right. So there you go. You heard the little click. That means it's correct. It's a little bit fiddly, but you'll feel it when it's correct because it really does lock into place. I'm a little bit disappointed at the actual sticky pad itself, because if I show you now, if I grab hold of this, the unit itself, the Mantis, and do this, you can see I can wiggle it, and that's not because of the adapter being a bad fit, that's actually the sticky pad that they've chosen to use, which is quite a thick, soft sticky pad. So it's not even the adhesive, it's like the foam stuff that pads it. I think that this won't be a problem, it maybe even will absorb some vibration and give us a cleaner movement trace, but it's not a great fixing. I really do think it would be better if they had adapted this system to actually just fit on sight tracks, on the extension bar itself. So hopefully that's something that will be forthcoming in the future from Mantis. Okay, it's fixed on anyway, so let's take it for a run out.